Hey everyone, good afternoon. Just getting set up for our 1 o'clock exercise class. So as you are tuning in, welcome. Thanks Sarah for the yoga class and Kate for your nutrition session. So I'm just getting set up for class. We're gonna do a cardio and core focused workout. So this will be all level friendly. You might wanna have a chair nearby in case you wanna do any of these movements seated. Of course, water, maybe a towel. Hi there, Trudy, welcome. So for our workout today, again, we're gonna do cardio and core. And so what I'm gonna have us do is alternate a minute, 60 seconds of cardiovascular conditioning, and then we'll do 30 seconds worth of a core strengthening exercise. So cardio and core, 1 minute of cardio, 30 seconds of core. If you are just jumping on, welcome, happy Tuesday afternoon. Hey Diane, welcome. Hi, hi. Hello, hello. I'm just checking my volume. Okay. So let me know if I am coming through okay as far as the sound. I think visually it's all working. Thumbs up. Okay, good. Sounds like, or it looks like I am coming through okay. So I've got right at 1 o'clock. We're going to just start with a seated or standing march in place, big shoulder rolls up, back, and down. Hey there, Andy. Hey, Mark. Up, back, and down, big shoulder rolls, seated or standing. Do a quick check of your posture. So shoulders come up, back, and down, keeping the chest lifted. Bend the arms and march in place. All right, hey Liz. So as you were coming on to the workout, welcome, happy Tuesday afternoon. We're gonna take it to a wide march. So the focus of our workout today is gonna be cardio and core. So 1 minute of cardiovascular conditioning, followed by 30 seconds, take it back to a narrow march, 30 seconds of a core strengthening movement. So for example, we might do jumping jacks for 1 minute, your version of a jumping jack, and then do a plank for 30 seconds. So those are the types of things we're gonna be doing. You want water, you want a cleared floor space, take it back out to a wide march, arms are bent, chest is lifted. One of the movements we'll do would be a jump rope. We usually do this with an imaginary air rope. Go ahead and take a curl back. But if you have a jump rope handy and you want to incorporate that instead of doing an air rope, that is a great option. Okay, looks like we're coming through okay. A few more leg curls. Nice full breath. Still just warming up the body. Let's take our feet wide, arms extend, and we're just going to rotate. So let your arms just kind of extend alongside or out to the side. Belly muscles pull in. Good. so our first segment, hey there Samantha, our first segment we're going to do a bob and weave. So that movement, we're going to bob down, we're going to come up, I'm going to add a punch, bob, weave, and punch for 1 minute. After that, we're going to take a seat, whether it's to a chair or the floor, and do our Russian twist or elbow tap. So I will let us know when we're starting and stopping. So let's get set up for the bob and weave with a punch for 1 minute, begin. So you want to take a wide stance, belly muscles pull in, you're going to bob down through the center, shift your weight, weave to one side, rise tall. I'm adding a punch or a reach. You could just do the bob and weave without. So the tempo is up to you. You choose how fast you're moving. We're coming up on halfway. So we're halfway through our 1 minute of cardio of the bob and weave. If you're getting a little bit tired, more tired than you want, make these smaller, stay up taller. Otherwise, get low, shift, and extend. About 15 more seconds. Zip up the belly. Nice extension if you're adding that punch. All right, that was 1 minute of our cardio. Now we're gonna do 30 seconds for the core. The core can be done seated in a chair, on the edge of the couch, on the floor. And we're gonna do our Russian twist or the elbow tap. So you're going to take the hands in front, you can interlace or have them separated. You're going to hinge back, turn, and tap elbow to the floor. 30 seconds, begin. Modification, just focus on the turn. You don't have to worry with the elbow tap. Belly muscles zip up strong. Very important that we're doing a controlled turn. 10 more seconds with good posture. So strengthening the muscles in the sides of the body, internal and external obliques. All right, and rest. So we're going back, 1 minute cardio, and we're gonna do our air rope. So unless you have a jump rope handy, I actually have a jump rope I'm going to attempt to do. 1 minute jump rope. If you don't have a jump rope, it's the imaginary rope coming forward, and I'll let you know when we're at the halfway point so you can then take the jump rope in reverse. Okay, 60 seconds, 1 minute cardio conditioning, begin. So you could do a march, you could do a hop, you could do a jog in place, that are jump rope or air rope. Keep the chest lifted. And we are at the halfway point, 30 seconds. So you might reverse the direction that you're jumping rope or using your imaginary jump rope, the air rope. I don't think I'm gonna go backwards. I'm gonna stick to forwards. Almost done, about 10 more seconds. We're gonna deepen the breath, get the heart rate up. All right, and rest. Our next movement is gonna be a plank for 30 seconds. Now you can do this on the wall, you can do this on the floor. If you happen to have a couple of paper or plastic plates nearby, we're gonna do a plank tuck. So 30 seconds, option to hold your plank wherever you can safely and successfully hold a plank for 30 seconds. For more challenge, bring your feet onto a paper or plastic plate You can be with straight arms or bent arms. 30 seconds, begin. So you might choose just to hold your plank or add the tuck, tucking into a ball and then shooting the legs back behind you. Keep the shoulders down, out of the ears. We've got about 10 more seconds. And rest. Nice job. Take a moment, loosen up the wrists. Roll out the shoulders, wiggle out the fingers. Anytime you need a sip of water, please help yourself. All right, if you're still with me, give me a thumbs up. I'm coming through okay. You can hear and see. Also, if you've got a number on that scale of exertion you want to throw out, let us know how you're feeling. So check in with your breathing, roll out the shoulders. Just try and keep the body moving before we go back to 1 minute of a cardio conditioning movement. Okay, thank you for the thumbs up. Appreciate it. Liz, nice job, thank you for that number. All right, coming up. March or jog in place for 1 minute. This can be done seated, not a problem. All right, 1 minute, march or jog in place, begin. March or jog. You choose the tempo. The arms can be bent. You could add bigger arms. That's going to help get the heart rate up a little bit higher, a little bit faster. So march or jog in place, seated or standing. Shoulders are back, chest is lifted. We are halfway through our 1 minute of cardio conditioning. After this, we're going to do 30 seconds worth of a bicycle. March or jog. I hope y'all are breathing hard. I certainly am. Less than 10 seconds. And rest. Nice job. The core movement we're going to do for 30 seconds is the bicycle. You can do this standing, you could do this seated, or you could do this on your back. Standing is going to be great for your balance. Seated is a nice option if you're feeling a little bit unsteady, and on your back is going to be a lot more intense on the core, so on the belly muscles and the back. So get set up. 30 seconds, bicycle, begin. So I'm going to come onto my back, fingertips behind the ears, elbow turns and points to the opposite knee. Keep the chest lifted, even though we are turning the upper body. Belly muscles zip up strong. About 5 more seconds. And rest. Nice job. Okay, shake it out. Anytime you need water, please help yourself. Coming up next, we're gonna do 1 minute of high knee. So a moment ago, we did a march or a jog in place. The high knee is going to lift up higher. You can do this seated, not a problem. 1 minute, high knees, begin. So you want to lift the knee up higher. Now the hip flexors are working, but we want to make sure that the belly muscles pull in. That's where the lift actually starts. Arms can be bent, or you can add a pull down with your high knee lift. You could take this high knee to a jog if you want more intensity. That definitely is a lot more intense for me. So I'm going to keep it here with the reach, pull down as the knee comes up, about 20 more seconds. Keep the chest lifted. If you need to modify, make it smaller or take it slower. 5 more seconds. And rest. Whew, good job. 30 seconds worth for our core exercise. We're going to do mountain climbers. So the mountain climber can be done against a wall, a sturdy chair, or down to the floor. The mountain climber speed is up to you. But the movement, we tuck one knee in towards the chest, set the foot down, and the other knee, and switch. So you can make these big or small, take them fast or slow. Please keep good form in your plank. 30 seconds, mountain climbers, begin. So shoulders out of the ears, spread your hands wide, your fingers wide, push down through the fingertip, the knuckles, the palm of the hand, and the heel of the hand. 10 more seconds. Navel starts the pull. So this actually starts around the deep belly muscles. And rest. All right. Grab some water. Loosen up the wrists. Roll out the shoulders. And on that scale of exertion, go ahead and give me a number. Hey, Lynn Wilkie, on that scale of exertion, what number would you say you're feeling? And there's no right or wrong number. So you just want to check in. How do the lungs feel? How does the whole body feel? Good. So we're coming up a little bit higher on the scale now that we've warmed up. Excellent. Any other numbers you've got to throw out there? Excellent. Nice, nice job. So we're going to do another segment or another section of cardio for 1 minute and core for 30 seconds. So we're going to do a curl back. That movement is a wide stance. You're going to curl one heel up towards your tail and then the other. So the curl back, heel comes up to the tail for 1 minute. And begin. So option to rest the hands on the hips or on the back of a chair or a couch. If you want a little more, extend the arms and pull back. You could reach the arms up higher and pull out. Good. Or you could reach the arms overhead and pull down. Good. We are coming up on the halfway point. So if you need to move faster or slower to get out what you want in this cardio burst, make some adjustments if you need to. When you pull the heel behind you, the foot is flexed, and we flex the foot to stabilize the knee. Less than 10 seconds to go. All right, and rest. Nice job. Our core movement, 30 seconds worth of either a seated knee tuck or a reverse curl. So the seated knee tuck, you're going to sit on the front edge of a sturdy chair, hands by your hips. Option one, you're going to pick up one knee, tuck it in, and then alternate. Option two, both knees tuck in. You could tap the heels or you could hover the heels. Otherwise, if you'd like to come onto your back, the reverse curl, knees are going to tuck in, heels are going to tap. So knees tuck and tap. Working the same area of the core body, just a different position under gravity. So that's going to give us a variation in intensity. 30 seconds. You choose seated knee tuck or reverse curl. I'm going to pull in strong and then tap with control, even if you're doing an alternating knee tuck on your back. 10 more seconds. Keep the belly button pulled in and up the entire time for low back support. Here's 3, 2, 1, and done. All right, let's see. Oh yes, okay. Up next, jumping jacks. So the jumping jack can be a full jack. It could be a half jack. It could be a seated full jack or a seated half jack. We want a nice full range of motion for 1 minute. Jumping jacks, begin. So whichever option you're choosing is excellent. Check in with your posture. If you need to mix and match along the way, feel free to do so. The main thing is we just want to keep the body moving. We want to keep the heart rate elevated to get the most benefit for the cardiorespiratory system. Strong lungs. We are past the halfway point. See if you can push it till the end. Keep it up. And rest. Roll it out. Shake it out. All right, still with me? Good, good work. 30 seconds worth. Coming up, our core strengthening move is going to be a boxer's crunch. Option to do this seated on the front edge of a chair. You're going to hinge back, fists come up by your face. You're going to turn and punch, and then turn to the other side and punch. So that would be one option if coming onto your back is not a good one, a good choice for you today. Otherwise, the boxer's crunch, you're going to come onto your back, still take those loose fists up by your jawline. You're going to curl, crunch, punch to one side, come down, and other side. So we have a little rotation. Get ready, get set, and go. 30 seconds worth of the boxer's crunch. So it's a turn and punch, whether you're seated in a chair or you're down on your back. We're halfway through. One hand extends, the other hand stays up by your jawline. Almost done. And rest. I felt those. Okay, we're about 20 minutes or so into our workout. Let's do another check-in with our scale of exertion. If you are still with me, give me a thumbs up. Maybe you've got a number you can share. Just let me know how you're feeling at home. And this is very much individualized. There's no right or wrong. But we want to make sure we're getting the most bang for our buck. So take a moment, catch your breath. Nice, good job. Mark, if you're still watching, I'm drinking my Pringles. He thinks this looks like a can of Pringles, which it does. It's actually water. Okay, Liz, Trudy, Lynn, thank you so much for weighing in. That really helps. All right, we are back to cardio, back to our cardio segment for 1 minute. Diane, excellent, thank you. For 1 minute, we're gonna go back to our jump rope. So if you have a jump rope, you wanna give it a whirl, excellent. Otherwise, air rope forward for 30 seconds. I'll let you know when we're halfway, and then take it in reverse for 30 seconds. You are welcome to do these seated, absolutely fine. Absolutely fine to do these seated. So we're wanting to push it 60 seconds on the clock. I'm going to see if I can do the jump rope. And begin. So 60 seconds. Whether you're choosing the jump rope or the imaginary jump rope, the air rope. If you're doing the air rope, lower body can march, can hop, jog. You can do heel lifts. All right, coming up halfway, 30 seconds. Take your air rope the other direction. I am going to keep going forward just so I don't hurt myself trying to go backwards. So if you are choosing a hop or a jog, we are getting the bone density benefit. Almost done. And rest. Nice, nice work. We're going to go back to our plank or plank tuck. So the plank can be done against the wall with straight or bent arms. It can be done on the edge of a sturdy chair, or it can be done on the floor. If you want to up the intensity and make this plank more dynamic, if you have a paper or plastic plate nearby, we're going to take one under each foot, and we're going to do a plank tuck. Plank tuck. All right, spread the fingers wide. 30 seconds on the clock, begin. So if you want to add the tuck, in and out. If you want to do this on bent arms, that works as well. I actually find it harder. Halfway through. 10 more seconds, keep breathing. Last 5 seconds. And rest. Nice, nice job. Roll it out. Loosen up the wrists. Wiggle out the fingers. Towel and water if you need it. All right, we're going to do a few more cardio and core move standing, and then we're going to come onto our back or seated and finish up there. All right, we're going to do our jumping jacks. Option to add a front kick. So option one will just be jumping jacks for 1 minute. Seated or standing. Option two, seated or standing, one jack and a front kick. One jack and a front kick, and you're going to alternate. So one jack, front kick, one jack, front kick. Even if you're doing half a jack, it works. So 1 minute jacks or option to add in the kick. You choose and begin. So jack, kick, you choose how high the kick goes. To modify, keep the kick low, or you might even do a heel tap. Otherwise, explore a full range of motion. When we add the kick, we're upping the challenge to our core, our balance, and our flexibility. We are halfway through. Keep the belly muscles pulled in for low back support. Remember, you're going at your own speed. About 10 more seconds. Keep it up. Job. Good work with the jack and the front kick alternating. We did that for 1 minute for our cardio. We're going to do 30 seconds now. Mountain climbers, Last time we alternated a knee tuck to the chest, just right up the center. This time, we're gonna have the option to pull the knee across to the opposite elbow. Remember, you can do these on the wall, the floor, or anywhere in between. So option to just bring the knee center, or bring the knee across as if it were gonna touch the opposite elbow. Catch your breath, check your form. I'm gonna get the clock ready for 30 seconds. Hands are spread, fingers are spread out wide. 30 seconds, begin. So mountain climber, you can go right up the center or take it across. Please make sure you're using good form to get the most out of the movement and to protect the body. Halfway through. Less than 10 seconds. And rest. Nice job. Loosen up the wrists. Roll out the shoulders. Shake it out. Grab some water. Check in with that scale of exertion. Last time I'm gonna have you check in on that scale of 1 to 10. Give me the number that you're feeling right about now. See if you can deepen your breath. See if you can take a fuller inhale through nose or mouth and a longer exhale through nose or mouth. So just bringing that intensity down a little bit. So on that scale of exertion, if you want to share your number, feel free. Again, there's no right or wrong. I would say I got up maybe, eight and a half, nine and a half. Nice job. So the goal is to push it until we're up higher on that scale, and then give ourselves some time to let it come back down. Excellent job. Okay, so we're gonna come to either a standing or a kneeling all fours position. So if kneeling is not a good option, you can use the wall or a sturdy chair. We're gonna do our bird dog crunch. If you are okay kneeling, we're gonna come to an all fours position. An all fours position. So hands in line with shoulders, knees directly underneath the hips. Go ahead and hunch your shoulders up to your earlobes. Get it out of your system. And then pull the shoulders down. Lengthen the back of the neck. So out the crown and the tail, we're extending a long line. Let's take the right leg back, flex the foot, and the left arm overhead, reach the fingers. We're gonna pull left arm to right knee, round back, and then reach and continue. We're gonna do 30 seconds for each set. Begin, so reach and pull. Inhale and exhale. The pull starts at the navel, and then we draw in the opposite limbs. Check in with your right shoulder. Careful it hasn't crept up to your right earlobe. And check in with your right elbow. Make sure it hasn't locked out. About 5 more seconds. And rest. Nice job. Loosen up the right wrist in particular. Roll out the shoulders. Let's get set up for the bird dog crunch on the other side. So whether you are standing or kneeling, check your base of support, very important. Shoulders come out of the ears. Take your left leg straight back and hold it there. Take your right arm overhead and hold. So the movement, again, we're gonna bring elbow to opposite knee, round the back, and then extend. 30 seconds, begin. Check in with your breathing. Just be careful you're not holding the breath. To support the low back, we want to think of the deep belly muscles, the transverse abdominals, pulling in and up. We're halfway through. Last 10 seconds. Strengthening the abdominals, the lower back, the hips, the gluteals, all part of the core. Woo! And rest. loosen up the wrists, roll out the shoulders, taking a seat or coming on to your back. So just a little bit more of our core and stretch, and then you guys will be good to go. So seated or onto your back. If you're seated, you're going to do flutter kicks where your legs extend and you're just going to scissor one leg on top of the other leg. If you're on your back, we're going to do flutter kicks as well. Hands are going to come by your hips or you can tuck them underneath your tail. So for 30 seconds, flutter kicks. You're going to extend your legs and crisscross. One leg on top, open and switch. That's a quick switch. If you're on your back, to make this easier, take your legs up higher to the sky. To intensify, bring your legs down lower. We're past the halfway point. And if you prefer, you can lift the head and tuck the chin. Less than 10 seconds. And rest. Nice, nice job. Set the feet down, open the feet up a little bit wider than your shoulders, arms out to the side, and begin to shift the weight of your legs side to side. So just shifting the bent legs side to side. We're going to take a deeper stretch for the outer hip and IT band. And I hope you all can still see me. I think you can. It just looks dark from down here. We're going to take our legs and drop them over to the right side. So our legs are bent and they've dropped to the right side. If this feels like plenty of stretch, stay right here. Belly muscles stay pulled in to support the back. If you'd like to explore this stretch further, take your right ankle and rest it on top of your outer left knee. So we're using the weight of the right foot to gently deepen the stretch in the outer left hip and thigh. So the IT band, the iliotibia band. And then safely release, uncross, or unstack the right ankle. And we're going to shift the legs over to the left side. So if this feels like plenty of stretch, just stay here. For more stretch, gently place your left ankle on top of the outer right knee. So the weight of our left foot is going to deepen the stretch just a little bit for the outer hip and outer thigh. Noticing how this side compares to what we felt in the other side. And gently release the left foot, bring your legs back to that shifting side to side, that side to side shift. From here, however you are comfortable coming to a seated position, whether you are seated on the floor or you're seated up in your chair, we're gonna bend one leg and extend or straighten the other leg. So one leg bends, the other leg straightens. You're gonna turn your body towards the straight leg, pull the shoulders back, and begin to hinge forward from the hips. So we're beginning to lengthen the back of our extended leg. If this is really, really tight, come on up, and then come back forward so you can add some movement into this stretch. And let's switch. So straighten the bent leg, bend the straight leg, turn your body toward your straight leg, and begin to hinge forward. When you feel a pull in the back of your extended leg, that's as far as you need to go. Check in with your breathing. If this is really, really tight, you might have to ease out of the stretch and then come back into it. One more inhale and exhale. Nice job. Sitting comfortably in the chair or on the floor, take some big shoulder rolls. Excellent job. Drop the shoulders down. Let the chin tuck towards the chest. So we want the weight of our head to fall forward and then gently roll the weight of your head. down through the center and over to the other side. So a few of these half circular neck rolls, being careful not to let the weight of our head fall unsupported behind the body. And we do have core muscles up in our neck. Anything that attaches to the spine is considered part of our core. So we want to strengthen these neck muscles, which we did, and now we're giving a little stretch. The next time the weight of the head comes center, just hold it down, the chin tucks. And then inhale, eyes come up. Exhale, big shoulder roll and release. Great, great job. Give yourself a hand. Nice work. Thank you all for joining me and tuning in. Have a great rest of your day, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.